Hi guys, welcome back to Bella's Big Adventures. My name's Sue. And today I've come along to the van. It's freezing cold again, as I always seem to speak to you when it's cold. But I've come early in the morning. It's -5 and sunny at least. But I've got to set up the van ready for our trip back to the UK. This time it's going to be slightly different because we are actually leaving Slovakia and moving back to the UK. I have mixed feelings about that. I love Slovakia. We've had a fabulous time here and we've been here for 7 years now. But yeah, it's time to move back. We miss all our friends and family, although we have made some fabulous friends here too and we will miss them greatly. So I have to get the Hymer ready. It's been sitting here unused since we got back after New Year, and that's a whole other story I'll tell you about later on. But yeah, so I've been crazily tired because we've been packing the house up ready for the move. As you can see, there is a mountain of boxes that we've had to pack all by ourselves, just getting the apartment ready for the next people. So cleaning, packing, and generally being exhausted. That's what's happened to us over the last few months. We also had a bit of an issue with the van. The right-hand headlight decided it didn't want to have an indicator or a daylight running light. We did ask the garage and they told us that we needed a brand new headlight and the loom at a total cost of about 1,500 euros for the part and an additional fitting fee, obviously. If any of you have Hymer and you're not part of the Hogs Facebook group, it's well worth joining because they're a font of knowledge. If you've got a problem, they usually know how to fix it within a few minutes. They said to have a look at the loom, so we did that. We took the light out. Doug managed to repair it. The garage problem is that they wanted us to replace a perfectly functional headlight and replace it with another one just because the wiring was broken. A bit disappointed with Hymer on that one. I have got a whole carload of stuff that I need to unpack. Put things away, ready for the start of tomorrow's journey. We are heading off into the Tyrol. So we're going to take 4 days. I have booked campsites all bar one night where we're heading for an air. Love this underbed storage, especially when you can lift the bed up and actually gain access from the top. I've taken the hanging rail out. We used to use it for coats, but it's not actually quite tall enough. So this trip, we are going to be bursting at the seams, I suspect, but we have got plenty of payload, so it shouldn't be a bother. Hi guys, well, it is now the next day and we are on the road, as you can probably hear by the traffic noise. We've just stopped at a service station. We are on the way to Camping Seeblick Toni in the Tyrol. It's a beautiful sunny day, freezing cold as always at this time of year. But yeah, so I'm not sure whether we'll get there before it goes dark, but if we do, I will show you around. If not, I'll do it in the morning.
Get out there and have an explore. What a view.
Morning guys. Nice, fresh being cold morning. Yeah, some beautiful mountains around us. So we're just gonna have a little explore. There's a big lake down here apparently and it's frozen solid. So I'm gonna have a quick look. Gotta get up this slope first. There's a little chapel at the end of the parking area over there. It is quite a big campsite and it's won lots of awards. And there are some fabulous new huts over there too. So I've got a little playground here, but look at all the ice down by the swings.
Right, well, Doug's just gone to pay. It's a really nice campsite. Obviously, it would look even better in the summertime. So today we are heading towards Lake Constance, and we're actually staying there this time. We passed by it last time and didn't actually stay anywhere. So we've actually got another campsite booked, Wirthshof or something like that it's called. I'll put the name up on the screen so you can see it. Okay, and I'll video anything fabulous that I see on the way. Hi, we've just had to stop because we've had a few issues with the Go Box, which is the toll booth charger. It's really annoying. As you go through every barrier, it tells you, it bleeps to say you're spending more money. And the tolls in Austria are huge, especially on a twin axle motorhome. So the joy of owning a big van means you pay more money to use the road, which is fair enough, but we have covered about 700 kilometres and so far we've spent over 250 euros. And we've just hit the road again, main road again, and it did four bleeps, which we've never had before. Doug had put another 100 euros on it, and it went from the two bleeps, which is normally telling you that you've got 30 euros left and you need to drive to the nearest garage to top it up. It went from two to four instantly to say, that hasn't been charged, please go to a garage and pay what you owe us and put some more money on. And I think we've still got another 100 kilometres to go, so I suspect he's put another 100 euros on. So it's not the cheapest to walk through, to drive through Austria. But it is beautiful because we're driving through the Tyrol Mountains. Here's Douglas, having put some more money on the Go Box. Did they say anything? They had to unlock it or something, didn't they?
Well, there's 1 euro still left on it.
1 euro. Yeah, so spent a bleeding fortune on roads, but hey. And petrol at the service stations here is 2.24, which is ridiculous because it's 1.56 back in Slovakia.
For diesel, not petrol.
So we're not actually filling up at the moment. We've still got about half a tank, haven't we?
More
than half a tank. So hopefully we'll get into Germany before we have to put any more money in. Morning guys, we are at Wirthshof. Can't remember how you say it. Anyway. We're at Wirthshof, I think, near Lake Constance. You can't see it from here, we're miles away. But we are just going to go and have a little explore because there is a camper clean here, which we've never used before. And basically you put your toilet cassette in and it cleans it for you to save you doing it. So have you got a euro? Doug's kindly coming to help me because I've no idea how it works and I'd like to video it for your use. So let's go and see what we've got to do. It's a very quiet campsite. Apart from us, yeah. Lots of permanent pictures, but lots of nicely spaced pictures with grids down with grass on the top. So, and it's frozen today, so it's all good. Right, let's see. We've got bike. And here. We've got a machine. Let me just have a look. So it says it's a euro. You choose your variety of toilet cassette by pressing this one. So we've got to press number one, put your coin in. You've got a coin.
We're just going to do that.
Right, put your coin in. Maybe it's not. Oh well, there you go.
It's not on.
Doesn't look like it's got any power. Maybe it doesn't work in the winter time. But anyway,
That would have been quite interesting. So basically, you put your toilet cassette in there, choose your toilet cassette. Take the slider off, press the button, open the vent, and it cleans it all for you, empties it out, and adds some bio cleaner. But unfortunately, it's not on. So that's annoying. Best laid plans and all that. But it's worth trying. It would have been interesting. I haven't tried one before. So yeah, I'll just show you the facilities. So here we have got the laundry room and washing up and hand wash. So again, we've got Miele washers and dryers and 3 Easy B dishwashers, which just rinse your washing, and some dishwashing and some strobing lights. As I say, the pitchers have got these sort of grids on, and they've all got power and waste, I think. They're nice and quiet, lots of permanent pitchers. There is a restaurant here, which is very popular. We went over at 7 o'clock last night and couldn't get in because it was packed. And they asked us if we'd booked, which we hadn't, obviously. But anyway, it looked very nice, very cosy and welcoming. Yeah, a little pitch and put. A sort of table pitch and put as well. That's funny. So there is a kiddies playground up here as well. And there is an outdoor swimming pool, but it's only open from May. The gate's closed, but there's a nice big boat-themed climbing frame there. So although I've paid for a pitch with water and waste, the water's obviously turned off. That's the restaurant there. It did look very cosy last night. They got fairy lights on these pleached trees. So that's reception there, which is also not open in the winter. You have to go to the hotel reception, which is just behind it. Yeah, this is where reception normally is. But as I say, you have to check in at the hotel. So, flying tour of this. Today we are driving further into France, I think. Possibly heading for an air tonight instead of a campsite. In Toul, T-O-U-L. Assuming there's space. And the problem with travelling at this time of year is that a lot of things are closed. And water supplies are definitely closed. It goes all the way down there. And there's, as I say, lots of permanent pitches with awnings and permanent caravans. Actually, the first 3 rows are reserved for people with dogs. So not all the campsite allows dogs. And the dog walk is behind those caravans at the end there. It's just a big field. But good to let the dogs run around. Okay, this is us. We are ready to set up, I think. Okay, we will speak to you later.
Well, there's no spaces.
No spaces. Right, okay.
having a little bit of a disaster. We've been following, we stopped at an air which was not suitable. Toul was full. The next air was bikers everywhere. And then we followed the sat nav, which was a huge mistake because we're now on a dirt track which is really slippy and we're having to reverse down it and it's really muddy and we're sliding everywhere. Doug's not amused, so I won't video anymore.
Morning guys. Last night was a complete disaster. We were aiming to go to Toul, as I possibly said. I can't remember in the panic. We got there in a beautiful town. I will put in some pictures because we didn't get to look round. But it was full when we got there, and it was about 4:30, so I think you need to be quite early. So then we went to a different place, which was in a small village called Brewley, I think, and it was very pretty. We went for a little stroll, took the dogs for a wee, and then we made some dinner. But the youths came out with motorbikes and quad bikes, and they were sort of zipping around. I mean, it was quite early, but we were a bit paranoid about it after our last trip. So we decided to move on, and we came to this Lac du, I can't remember what it's called, I'll look it up. And the road was fairly good until the last minute, and then the sat nav, for some god awful reason, decided to take us down a footpath. And at the start of it looked like a sort of single track road, so we sort of risked it a little way in, but then promptly got stuck in the mud, and there was nowhere to turn around because the fields each side were soaking wet. So we had to reverse out, and that didn't go so well either. So we got the mud mats out, and we did a lot of backwards and forwards and reversing and splattering mud everywhere as we went. I mean, look at the state of the car. I mean, the van is splattered, properly splattered. I mean, it wasn't that clean to start with, but it is absolutely filthy now. But we've woken up by a really picturesque lake, apparently. But it's really foggy. But anyway, we have to go out because we've got the dogs and we have to go for a walk. So we're going to have a stroll. This place is enormous. I'll look up what it's called. I can't remember. But there are little chalet sort of houses behind here. There's two or three airs and campsites. And it was quite dark when we got here, wasn't it? It was quite dark to see. See, there are pictures with water and electricity, but this is quite muddy as well. In a minute, Bonnie's eager to get going, aren't you? Eager to get going. We didn't plug in because by that point we just wanted to get the mud off us. We were absolutely covered in it. But as you can see, there's quite a lot of parking spaces over there as well. There are some little wooden hut things over there. And there is a marina not far away, apparently. That's probably it over there, that building over there, I would imagine, if you can see it in the fog. And the lake is just over there behind Doug. So we're going to go over there and have a look, see what we can see.
Yeah, this trip's been a bit of a disaster, to be fair. The weather's been dreadful. We got stuck in the mud. We've been to a couple of airs. I mean, I even booked campsites for three of the nights so that we were guaranteed to have some water and possibly showers, because the journey back last time was also a complete disaster. We didn't film it because Doug was poorly with flu, and we got delayed for 2 days, and then we set off slowly, and then both dogs got sick, one after the other, so that was also a disaster. So I didn't bother filming, and we ended up at some places where there were a lot of youths driving around with late at night honking their horns and revving their engines or revving motorbikes and stuff. So, which is why we moved from the last one last night, because we didn't get any sleep that night. And yeah, so anyway, we're going back to the UK mainly because you know, we've been away now for 7 years, and as much as we love Slovakia and the weather and the people we met have been fabulous, we need to get back to friends and family. We're all aging somewhat now and various ailments and things, and we miss our friends too. So yeah, time to head on home. So the plan is that we drive the dogs back in the van to stay with my mum for a week, and then Doug and I are going to fly back to Bratislava to oversee the removal men, and then we will drive our car back, and we're going to stay at a couple of really nice hotels. So we spent a good hour and a half this morning, Doug cleaning the
mud mats from last night's disaster. And cleaning the van out, it was just everywhere. It was on practically every surface. So we've made some coffee. We're going to hit the road and we're heading off into Belgium now. We are at the farm, as I said earlier, and it's a lovely frosty, no, actually foggy morning, misty morning. This is the campsite. It is very simple. There's some tent spaces and van spaces and warm food. And it's mostly grass, but it's nice, quiet, peaceful. We're on the only gravel bit, really. But as you know, it's a working farm, so there are bits of machinery and things around. A bit of gravel area, there is electric hookup. We've got some bins here. It's the entrance. Caravan area over that side. You can get fresh bread. It gets delivered at 8 a.m. Female showers in here. Let's have a quick look. It's also storing the ice cream at the moment, but this is the new female shower block. Quite nice showers. They're obviously new. New sink, a little bin, a little seat, big rain shower overhead, and no press button, which is my favourite. So they're quite good. The toilet block at the moment is still quite basic, and as far as I'm aware, it's shared. Is that toilet or shower? That's baby changing. But as I say, the toilet block at the moment, it's not worth videoing. It's a unisex toilet. But there are urinals in it, which I find a bit weird, because who wants to stand having a pee when there's women and children walking past you? But anyway, but maybe they're upgrading, because next to it there is an enormous room which looks like they might be making a bigger restaurant. There is a cafe here, but we got our wires crossed last night and we thought we were going to eat there. And Doug was saying they didn't open till 8:30, which I said is very late, so we waited, and I think it shut at 8:30 because there was no one to be seen. Here we've got some picnic tables for the summertime. And a little pond. Looks like they might keep geese or something in summer. So that's reception there. And here we've got washing up. Just external barns. Nice sliding doors though. They're not properly heated, so there is washing up too. Laundry as well, so there's a couple of washers and a dryer. It's €5, but I'm not quite sure. I think you must just pay the lady after you've used it, because there's no tokens or anything. There are two individual showers at the end there. As you can see, possibly, they appear to be renovating a big room here. So I think that's going to become possibly a restaurant or something. Here endeth the tour. That is literally it. It's really close to the Eurotunnel. It's about a 50-minute drive, and it's really close to some World War areas, World War II. Areas that you can go and visit, and they have got a donkey and a beautiful dapple grey horse. There's a pony in here. Hello. If it's you making the noise, you're a bit noisy. Eating their breakfasts, obviously. It's not the flattest of sights, obviously. As you can see, our front wheels are completely off the floor. that's us. We're heading off to the Eurotunnel now. I'm probably not going to video all of that unless something unusual happens, because we've done it a couple of times before. So, next stop, the UK. You're enjoying this video. If you are and you haven't subscribed yet, why not hit that subscribe button, ding that bell for future notifications so that you don't miss any of Bella's big adventures.